Yo, what's good, YouTube? It's your boy Slick.
YouTube, what's good?
It's your boy Slick. Welcome back to my channel. Man, first and foremost, before we get off into anything, I gotta say shout out to y'all, man, for real. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing that content, boy. But on today's episode, man, we're gonna get off into this B2200 build. Yes, finally. We were gonna wire it up, but I found out that there's more to it than what I just think. So you're gonna see us clear up a bunch of rat nests, or you're gonna see us get the SEMA build ready, because I'm taking this to SEMA. We ain't taking it to no SEMA. It's coming back in this garage, and we're gonna ground and pound it. Put these babies on. You wait, man. I got some special videos coming up, and I can't wait to give you all this juicy juice, dog. You heard? But man, like I said, first and foremost, man, let's get off into it. Man.
Only thing that we need is the coolant temp.
You hear this, man, what he just said? What did you just tell? What did you just say?
All we need is the coolant temp sensor.
So you said this is going to be simple?
Simple.
Here, look, tell the camera, man, tell him.
It's going to be simple.
My man. Hey, y'all, if y'all tuning in today, we get into some serious business, man. Today is wiring up day, baby. So check this out, man. Y'all stay tuned. Sorry for the wind. I can't do nothing about that. That's Mother Nature. But you know what I can do? I can show y'all how to do a KIA Sportage engine swap, baby.
We need to clean some of this shit up before we...
Yeah, no doubt, man. I mean, those are all vacuum ones from what I know. It looks like everybody always rips all that stuff out right there and just keeps this. I don't know what the hell this stuff is. But I know for a fact all that stuff is always ripped out in other people's builds. I'm about to show y'all how to get this bad boy wired up. I got the homie Kyle here today. Man, today's gonna be a successful day. I also got the cat. We're about to let her out the bag because, boy, she is jumping. This is a Mega Squirt ECU. This is what you're gonna need. This is the aftermarket ECU system that makes this engine run. And it's compatible with that transmission. All right, so that's my crankshaft position sensor right there. You know what I'm saying? I can't even say that word because it's a tongue twister. Either way, that thing's gonna get hooked up to this aftermarket ECU system. Even if it's wrong, we're gonna fire it up. Nah, it shouldn't be wrong. It shouldn't be wrong. We're gonna help y'all get it right. And we getting started on this, taking out all the stuff we do not need. We gotta take out some brackets right here so we can get to these coolant lines, which is my heater. And then there goes another heater, but there's brackets back here on this engine that we gotta take off. We're basically just trying to clean everything up right now so we can get on this wiring process. So what's this bracket right here? Just bullshit ass bracket we don't need.
It holds all these vacuum lines and all this old evap stuff, I think.
I don't understand why this truck has so much bullshit you did not need.
Well, it's from back in the day whenever this truck was like at the beginning of fuel injection. Like they didn't even, they thought it needed all this stuff.
It's crazy, dude. It's crazy to think that though, man, that you had to have so many things.
Crazy that it needed all this shit for the vacuum.
Dude, that's already looking clean. Look how clean that looks.
And then once we figure out...
Damn, you can eat food on that son of a bitch right there.
Once we figure out what exactly, if we need any of this wiring at all,
mm-hmm.
We can delete. I can go through, depin the harness, this harness, take out all this extra wiring, and then it'll just be like one nice harness coming over here to the headlights. Should be clean. You have all your room to put all your nice wiring and shit for yourselves and all that.
I'm down with that.
You'd even have room right here to put like all the fuses and shit. So we're definitely gonna need this one, this part of it. We gotta figure out what the rest of it is. This is probably the alternator. So we definitely need this whole entire plug, but I don't think we need anything off of this, really. We need to save that though.
So we just took this off right here. I don't think we need it. Plus, if we do need it, I need to figure out what this part is called because I don't even know what the hell that is. But I have vacuum lines on it, and we're most definitely probably just going to plug them off. You know, make them run into each other. Hopefully, I don't blow the engine. It creates so much vacuum, it pops this whole deal up. That'd be some wild shit. My luck, that's how it worked. I don't know what that is neither, but it was connected to that. So either way, we just took that off for right now. I've seen some other people's bills that weren't running them neither, so maybe it's not something you need for a Kia Sportage. I don't know. We'll figure on later in life. Right now we're just taking off brackets that are in the way that are gonna be holding us up to get into our coolant lines and stuff, and because that's my heater line, right?
Yep.
My heater cores. I got one right there and I got another one over there. Show where they're taking off right now.
I'm about to take the top part of the intake off so we can get to all the wiring underneath it.
Gotcha. So this bad boy right here is coming off. Yo, this thing's got so many vacuum lines, we're gonna call this the Kirby, baby. The vacuum line that a B2200 has is unbelievable. How many rubber hoses. Man, that kept a lot of manufacturer businesses back in business though, baby. You yeah, know, for sure. A lot of job security with that stuff. So I'm over here being cameraman right now, but I don't even think about it. I'm getting dirty too. You just ain't seeing it because I'm like a ghost. You know, I'm in and out like a crook. I'm in that thing and then I'm up out of there. So this back brace right here, that back brace you see, that right there is holding us. I'm actually getting to that right there. So we got to take that off so we can run hoses to my heater core. So I can have a heater for the winter, but man, this thing's going to be garage kept. She won't probably never see winter in her entire life. She'll never see it.
These things are tight. My hillbilly voice.
Shit, yeah, them things are tight, boy. She.
Shoot, that's that Oklahoma voice coming out, man.
I do this old bitch right here, boy. Put this old bitch on the 10th quarter mile around, boy. Ta-da. We got clear space, man. Look at those.
Sure. I think that's the cam sensor. And no clue what that wire does, but we'll have to figure it out.
I bet you it's a ground. It's got brown and white. But it would have been a full brown wire, right, if it was a ground?
Or maybe black. But it goes down to like a little diode looking thing or something.
Gotcha. So we gotta figure out what this wire is right here. It's definitely out of place and it's not connected to the harness of any sort. Like I said, they left me with an existing harness, but they didn't give me the original harness, so. That I was doing from the start, it was either buy an original harness or just go ahead and do the aftermarket harness, because with the aftermarket harness, you can actually run a turbo with this Kia Sportage. And if you're trying to be a racer, this engine can literally see about 500 horsepower is what people are saying. So that's pretty nice on all stock components too. So I might turn this bad boy into a ricer one day. You might see me popping popcorn. Could you imagine that, man? Me running down the highway, doing bed dancing, and letting this bad boy shoot a flame out the hood. Two-stepping with a dancing bed. Boy.
Wild shitting on people down the highway.
See, don't be taking my ideas. Bed spinning and me popping a two-step out the hood. Letting that son of a bitch spool up. And then just let it go. Dude, that'd be pretty dope, huh? That'd be a show. That's SEMA build right there, son. Don't even trip. All right, so vacuum lines are holding us up from actually getting this manifold off. Ta-da. We almost got a free manifold.
But wait, there's more.
Oh, yeah, more vacuum lines?
I think it's something coming, man.
This vacuum line. City, baby. Yeah, look, there they all go. All underneath.
I'm trying to delete all that.
Oh, yeah, son? Delete?
That just runs hot coolant through the throttle body.
Which ones do? The ones underneath?
The ones that I'm pulling loose.
So he's deleting, man, because we don't live in Antarctica. she's pretty.
Oh, it's bent.
So when they took it off of the vehicle, they bent it on me, on my ass? Yeah. Wow. I can already see the mechanism that's bent too. Look at it. It's right there.
Yeah. It's hard to...
Wow. You think I could bend that back with some pliers or something?
Maybe.
Listen, like I said, don't let things hold you up. We ain't gonna worry about that right now. What is this right here? This is just a coil pack.
Yeah, the whole thing is the spark plugs would be in there. But we can't use this in the swap because it doesn't have an igniter built inside of it. So we have to get LS coils or something like that that have a built-in igniter.
Right, so we can't use the original coil. Original coils for this then.
The Mega Squirt won't run the factory coils.
Damn, simple and plain. There was talks of people using CBR parts, CBR coil packs. I ain't never heard no stuff like that. We're just gonna try to see if we can use some LS one. There they go. And what's that on the top of that? Just glue? Some horse glue? Damn, what is that?
Water.
Water? Is that bad?
Not good.
Damn, son. So what was that?
That was nasty water.
No, but what is this?
Oh, that's the spark plug wire.
Spark plug wire, and there's water in it. And by the way, I bought this engine with 90,000 miles on it. And
there's water inside that hole, bro. The whole entire spark plug hole is full of water.
That's not good, bro.
We gotta figure out how to get it out of there.
Vacuum cleaner?
Maybe. You got like a shop vac?
I don't have a shop vac.
This is nasty water. You might not want to put it in like here.
Dog, I'm upset right now. How the hell has it got water in it?
I guess setting out, maybe.
Oh my god. Bro, that's horrible, bro.
Man. Well, I guess it's a good thing we did take this off. I mean, it's good and bad.
Oh my gosh, she's leaking, dog.
But at least it's on top of the spark plugs. So we just gotta figure out how to get it out of there.
I literally bought this engine from a big time company. I can't even think of what their name is right now, but give me some time because we're about to put their ass on Front Street. Selling me an engine with water and the spark plugs. What type of shit is that? Give me a second, because I'm about to tell y'all this company. Like I said, I'm pretty disappointed right now. I bought the engine off of Automotix. I bought it off of line. You know, they gave me the full rundown sheet. What is it, Carfax? Whatever sheet you want to call it, the diagnostic sheet. It should be a running engine with 91,000 miles on it. And I paid a pretty good penny for this engine. This engine ain't cheap. It costed me $1,100. With taxes altogether, came out to $1,200 for a KIA Sportage 1997 model. How stupid does that sound? Now, I tried looking on pull aparts. I tried looking in salvage yards. I couldn't find one of these engines around my area. So this one comes from, I want to say Colorado or whatever. I'll do some more research on that and let y'all know. But I'm just disappointed right now that I got water in my spark plugs, especially coming from a high tech auto mix or auto max. But auto mix, right?
Automotix.
That means they let this engine just sit outside.
This stuff's so old, dude.
You could tell, dude. It's been sitting out in the sun. Like you said, it's probably where that water comes from, man. It's been, just been sitting outside in their inventory.
Yeah, I think it's good, though, because the inside of the engine is what matters. We just got to get it out of there.
That's OG Steak and Ale?
The legend in steak. Steak and Ale. Never heard of it.
Hey, check this out, man. Welcome to my podcast, y'all. We just chilling right now and too smooth. What you think you want to do in the future, bro? I was just fooling around. Check me out, though, man. We about to get this bitch in drive. You ready to coast?
I'm going to turn up the treble real quick. You got the CD or the cassette, dog?
Yeah, bro. This truck right here, man. This was top of the line back in its prime, you know what I'm saying?
It was running back in 2008.
Was it? See? 2008. You know, that's the first time that glove box has ever been opened. What do you think, bro? You're looking at some dinosaur stuff right now, bro.
314 or something. Oh, a long time ago.
Hey, but the whole dash and everything, man, she is straight, dude. Man, who you know that got a cleaner dash than that, bro? Normally, these are all busted up. The clusters are all busted.
What the heck is this green stuff?
I even got the old school radio deck, bro, that used to bang too short on. Yeah, I think that's where the computer's at. I don't even think this needs to come off. I think the computer is right there at the kick panel. Aha! We have a computer, son. That right there is my old harness system.
I used to hate me, but you nice now. Yeah, one over there that you like now. Yeah, feed me lies, thought I would.
Bye. Alright, so all this wiring right there goes to all that old computer, and that's the boot we gotta take off.
Yeah, I think that's all we're gonna stop and take this.
This bad boy right here, we gotta take that off, and that's where that new ECU is gonna go through.
See if we can take this out and look back there. Because the dang wiring harness. You can't pull that boot out.
You can't?
No, because the air conditioning is right there in front of that piece.
Let's see. Bro, I'm about to hit you with a banger right here. This is called Dreamsicle. Here you go, fam. This is a shyster.
Are you kidding me?
She's not in there, is she?
No, the more of the air conditioning is in front of that hole. Like, you can look in there.
Bro, is that fucking slapper or what?
Damn.
I know, Dreamsicle, son. You thought she was on an island for a second,
huh? California dreaming, baby.
Yeah, son, I told you. This is how much change we have been through. Everything you see in the back of this bed was once underneath that hood. So, yeah. That's a lot of stuff.
So we got the boot off, as you can see. The mastermind is bringing out the wiring harness. Bam, there it goes.
These wires we don't need anymore, because this goes all to the factory, which will clean up the rest of all this.
Got you. Got you.
Processes.
Either way, though, now we can run that harness.
Through there.
Yeah, that aftermarket harness through the original boot where it comes from. So I'm pretty happy. Because like I said, we were thinking about mounting it out here or running it right there. Man, this is
going to be way cleaner over here.
Yeah, there was so much stuff that we needed to address today. But it was just a lot of prep work. So we can get ready for the next video on the next episode. We'll be wiring up this complete engine, hopefully. Today was just a lot of prepping, man. I didn't realize how much still needed to be done. But as you can see, we have accomplished a lot. We're not done yet. We're doing some tidying up and just trying to get a cheat sheet so the next time we come back here, the next episode, it'll be more simple and it won't be drug out so long. Can you imagine the person that was trying to come up with this?
Yeah, originally. I was like, oh, this wire does this and this.
He's trying to explain to people, well, man, that old green wire with the blue on it with just a little tad of yellow, that wire right there, that'll run your whole engine.
If you don't have that one plugged up, it ain't gonna run.
And then the person that he's talking about, they're like sitting there thinking like, what the hell is this dude talking about, man? Either way, shout out to the geniuses, you dig? The world don't turn without you. Check this out, man. He completely went away with all that wiring. And look how tidy and neat he is. Man, that's just nice, man. To me, that's nice.
Get it all cleaned up. Looking good. So I'm going to put that new wiring in here. Doesn't look like a spider web going everywhere, a wiring.
He got rid of all that junk. And this is the stuff you actually need to wire up your alternators and everything you're gonna need for that, your battery cables, your terminals, all the rest of that stuff was all for vacuum lines and sensors that you do not need no more. this right here chilling. This is all end cap stuff that we'll eventually figure out what it is.
So some of this might power up our new ECU. But this might be like the power and ground for the old ECU, which we can use to fire up the new ECU. That way we don't have to run the wiring from the ignition switch or anything like that. That way this thing is like bada bing, bada boom factory.
Bada bing, bada boom, son.
The most factory, unfactory engine that'll ever be put in here.
Hey, son, this thing right here, don't even worry about that. That's factory, son. So, man, we're going to call it a day. We cleaned up all the wires. I mean, the homie right here, he accomplished a lot today. All I did was shoot video of it to give y'all some reference points of how to do these things if you're by yourself. We're all learning this together, so keep on tuning in. But we're definitely going to call this just a day because this was a lot of prep work for the next video, so it's easier next time.
Yo, what's good, y'all? So as you can see, man, that truck had a lot of damn work to do today. I am not in it. He's not in it. We trying to enjoy our Sunday too. You probably won't see this video for a little while, but either way, that's what it takes to do aftermarket ECU system. And you got to go that route. You don't have to go that route with an aftermarket ECU, but you could probably use a original wiring harness, but you're still going to have to tap into all those wires and figure them out. We're all going to figure this out together. The homie right here, he did a lot today. He put in a lot of work, and man, that was just a lot of tedious bullshit. And hopefully we can all learn that together, because I learned a lot on how to be more organized with your wiring systems. That was a damn mess. It looked like a rat's nest, and he turned it into a full SEMA build at the end. I'll show y'all a walkthrough of that. I'll do a slow-mo video of that. It'll look fresh. But the next episode, we're going to accomplish way more.
The next episode, we're going to try to get the Mega Squirt all wired up, ready to go, get everything ready to fire up the engine other than the fuel system. After we get that video done, we'll be tackling the fuel system.
Yeah, I got to get that. I got to holler at Trent. The homie's got my standalone fuel system. I got to holler at his ass. He said, hey, bro, I got this for free. I'll give it to you. I'll help you out with the build. I got to get in contact with his ass. Trent, if you're hearing me, give me my shit, bro, so I can get going with this build. And we need to get this guy on camera with his build, because this guy right here, man, he's got a fucking build. That is amazing. But
just your basic run-of-the-mill, single cab, short wide, pickup, cat eye.
It ain't basic though, man. This man don't put the, he don't put the two-step in the Cajun sauce, man. This man got his sauced up, man. So we definitely need to have a sit down with this guy and get an interview with him with his next build. So like I said, the content is going to get crazy, man. The more subscribers, the more, what is it? The more umph you get me to give y'all this content. I got crazy content. This right here, this is a crazy man coming up right now.
Crazy man on the bike.
Hell yeah, crazy man Davis.
Davis on the bike.
Hey, check him out, man. He's coming through. Special guest, baby.
It's a whole bunch of wiring harness bullshit on there. Yeah. How's it going, brother, man?
Oh, I'm doing all right. How about you got it in the correct place and all that kind of like that? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Well, it looks good, man. Double overhead cam. Oh, it's a KIA motor.
Yeah. I'm doing an aftermarket ECU system also, so it's going to give it a little bit more power.
Yeah, you got to get the thing to get it wired up and all that.
It's there, yeah.
It's amazing what when the factory puts them together and all them guys, they don't ever think about the mechanics or anybody's going to have to work on it.
It's even crazier as they put all that shit on there. And then the engine can still run without 90% of that stuff.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
As you can see, we get special guests sometimes, and some of them are crazy. But hey, man, that guy right there, he's very knowledgeable. We just got to put it all together like a puzzle. Back to the homie, man. Thank you for coming through today.
Yeah, no problem.
We produced some good-ass content for y'all. I'm going to have to chop it all up, put it all together, and send it y'all's way. Either way, man, until next time, thank y'all for tuning into my channel. You hung out with your boy Slick and your boy Kyle, man. Peace out, man.